comment chat time. If you didn't listen to the show earlier this morning, every Monday we do a little something called Three Things from the Weekend, where Jess reads to you anonymously two sets of three things. Your job is to try to figure out which one of us did which set of three.
Who did what?
The things are as follows.
Person one, stumbled into some presidential campaigning, shopped at Trader Joe's, and played dentist. Person two, handed out lots of candy, had butternut squash mac and cheese, and went to the most unique gender reveal.
If you guessed that I was person one and she was person two, you'd be right.
Great job.
Congratulations. Great job. And our weekend chat video gives us a chance to tell you a little bit more about some of the things that we did. I stumbled upon some presidential campaigning. In my neighborhood, there was someone who drives a big white Ford pickup truck.
Uh-huh.
And on the truck, it says Trump 2020.
Okay.
A couple of American flags on it. The problem I had, I have no problem. Listen, showing love for whatever candidate you support is what makes America great,
yeah.
Right or wrong?
Yeah, you're allowed right? to do whatever you want.
The only thing is, you have to only take up one parking spot, no matter who you're supporting.
The parking spot is insane.
If you want to see the picture, I have it on my Facebook page. You can check that out. But I did want to say, I actually wound up talking to the guy who owns the truck.
Yeah.
He figured out who I was. I figured out who he was. And I told him, well, job well done on the truck. Just work on,
Parking needs a little help.
How do you back that bad boy in?
It's not a big truck too.
It was definitely not the way he parked the truck. He was off by just a little bit. I also went out to Trader Joe's in Connecticut on Saturday.
How was it? Busy?
Yes, but that store gives me, what did you call it?
Grocery store anxiety.
I got it.
I got it
for the first time ever because I felt like I was being pushed around the store.
Yeah.
I felt like I was on an escalator and I only had a couple of seconds in each section of the store.
Did you have to wait in the line to get in?
Yes.
Still?
Yes.
I remember because you went early too, right?
Yeah. I think we waited maybe 10 minutes outside. But once we got in, I'm like, I'm going past the specialty nut aisle and I'm like, oh, wait, I missed one.
You can't turn around.
Very, very heart palpitation-y for CJ.
Anxiety inducing.
Yeah, I felt like I needed eight drinks after that. I also wound up playing dentist, not on a human, thank God.
Oh, thank God.
But
the dentist.
My dog Smalls is losing his baby teeth.
Baby Smalls. And he
was spitting them out. He's going, bleh. And I'm like, oh my God, what is going on? Then I realized this is normal. The only problem I have is I don't know, is there a dog tooth fairy?
There could be.
Do I need to put it under the pillow and
treats, soft ones?
Yeah, please. Smalls, I got you. Soft treats are coming home. Your things were what?
I handed out lots of candy. On Friday, I went to a trunk or treat, had the wolf truck. We played some country music over at the new Eastdale Village over there on 44 in Pleasant Valley. It was a lot of fun. We almost ran out of candy. We had to send one of our friends up to the Walgreens to refill. We had to refill the Reese's.
Can I get three of the bags of 100 pieces, please?
Please.
Thank you.
Let us have that. I had butternut squash mac and cheese, which is from Trader Joe's.
So good.
Amazing. Yeah. Perfect wintry cold day meal. It was so good. 10 out of 10.
Add chili to it. I'm telling you.
I can do that.
Side it with chili and the butternut squash. Any food like that from Trader Joe's is priceless.
I mean, I hear Trader Joe's has the best kind of pancakes and specialty foods like that. But my favorite part of the weekend was I went to a gender reveal yesterday. Most unique gender reveal I've ever been to. My friends Amy and Hiro are expecting twins this fall, and they took us to the Mid-Hudson Bridge at 6 p.m. last night, and they lit up the bridge the color of the babies that they are having.
The gender reveal was?
A boy and a girl!
So half the bridge was
half the bridge was blue, the other half was pink.
Wow.
It went pink and blue, pink and blue, pink and blue, and
yeah.
Then at 6 p.m. it stopped.
That's really
it
cool.
It turned pink. And then they shuffled half of it to blue and half of it to pink. It was really cool.
That is really cool.
So if you saw
congratulations to them.
Yeah. I'm so excited. But if you saw the bridge lit up, I know it was lit up this morning on my way to work. I was like, it's still lit up. I was there last night.
Now, that's an idea you can't use
when
you decide to settle down and have children.
Maybe when I have kids, you can skydive and do a confetti balloon out of the sky.
Sure. Sure.
I just want you involved somehow.
Sure. I would be more than honored to be a part of your gender reveal.
And I'm not giving you the answers, what it is, until you get up in the plane.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
because
good.
I know.
I am awful with secrets. But I'm hoping now more than ever that this event happens sooner than later, because I don't know how much time I got left.
Well, you know what I mean? Go find someone to...
On that note, Bye-bye.